Brooklyn Independent Television.
Originally a stained glass craftsman and designer, Charles Flickinger began his impressive career in glass bending while working on the restoration of the Statue of Liberty torch. Now in Red Hook, Flickinger Glassworks does everything from architectural glass and windows to custom glass bending. How cool is that?
My name is Charles Flickinger, and this is Flickinger Glassworks on Pier 41 in Red Hook, Brooklyn. And we've been in this location for 20 years. Commercial light industry moved into this building in the early part of the century. We have about 6,000 steel molds. We're doing custom glass bending. We have 5 ovens, and we do everything from custom display cases, lighting restoration work, enamel tableware, sculptural work for architects, and then we do our own projects here as well. When I was young, just the physicality of glass really attracted me. My grandmother, she did ceramics work, so I was familiar with getting up in the middle of the night and going to the oven, and that's a lot of what we do here today. I started doing glass work professionally in 1974 as stained glass design and restoration, and then I started this business in 1985. And I was lucky enough to find 4 or 5 old-timers who taught me the trade. I spent years with them. That was where I got started, and we primarily focus on the glass bending today. Cello's gonna take a mold that's been preheating out of the annealer. So it's at about 900 degrees, I would say. And we're doing a series of lamp panels for this antique flush mount light fixture. He's going to move a piece of tableware out of the oven where we're working at 1200 degrees. And he's going to put that into the annealer. And then he's going to put a flat piece on this mold and make another panel for this light fixture. Of course, it'll take the shape of the mold. It takes about 15 minutes in the oven. So once we bend the glass in the oven at 1200 degrees, then the piece is moved to the annealer, and it's at about 900 degrees, and it takes the stress out of the glass. We let it cool, we take the glass out the next morning, then it's good and strong. The artistic influx here in Red Hook has been a lot to do with glass. I guess I was maybe one of the first glass artisans to move into this neighborhood. And then you get pure glass, of course, blowing glass. 1989 is when we moved in here. And at the time, we had to keep the front doors locked. You'll notice today, the doors are wide open and we've put in a showroom. That's been a big change. The neighborhood is safe. A number of very nice restaurants have opened up on Van Brunt Street. It's a very depressed neighborhood, always has been. The economy hasn't changed for those who live here. You know, there's still 18% unemployment in Red Hook, and it's always been that way, even during the good times. I didn't want to see the IKEA come in here. I was dead set against it. You know, they put in that ferry. There's been nothing negative about it. They did displace the boat docks, which, you know, displaced 100 jobs, but again, they're also providing some jobs.
He donates to charities, and he's done, you know, wildfire work, and he kind of built this company up from nothing. I mean, there was a point where he was out quoting the work, coming back here, blacksmithing a mold, cutting the glass, and bending it in an oven that he put together, you know, to do this job. And that's really incredible that he kind of had that passion and the fire in his belly to get this place up to where it is now.
We've done thousands and thousands of pieces of custom bent glass. Since we take a great deal of pride in our work, we have maintained high standards and as a result make very little money. You're not going to make money making a living with your hands these days. It's a very hard thing for me and any of the glass workers in the neighborhood to make a living, forget about making a profit, as a manufacturer in New York City. I think the beauty is that we can turn around at the end of each day and see what we've done. And we take a lot of satisfaction in that.
My name is Carmen Sparrow. I've been working on this series that has to do with armaments. And I've been building guns. This is an AK-47 done in an art glass. Basically what I do is I cut and polish and then laminate the glass in layers. The idea of the piece is as a catalyst for a discussion about guns. Hopefully it causes some interesting discussion.
So Eugene has just completed a bending in the big oven. He has three panels of glass that he's about to pull out. It's been a 3-hour cycle. And again, this glass was bent at 1200 degrees and it cooled and annealed in the same oven. This is an oven that we also built in 1985, 1986. We can bend a number of pieces at the same time. So it's decorative. It's going to go in a residential setting. So these are the pieces that we just completed in the large oven. And once we remove them and give them to our customers, they're going to be hand-silvered for residential application. And then pieces that we did yesterday in the same oven, we have two beds for this oven, was for a custom wall sconce. We take the flat panel, we put it on this unusual elliptical steel form. Over with time and temperature, the glass takes this shape. And I want to thank you all for coming to Red Hook, Brooklyn. We spend our lives here, and we'd love to have you come visit.
Follow us on Twitter at BK Independent TV.